Still in Barlinnie, still 1974. My cousin Jim McNaught was also sentenced in here with me. He joined me 6 months later from Stockton Prison for the young offenders, as he was 6 months younger than me. He was immediately picked on, bullied, mainly by thugs from Priest Hill and Pollock. I only found this out one day when Jim and I were in line waiting on buying supplies with our weekly wage, which was basically a couple of pence. So it was all toothpaste and Jim got tobacco. So while we're in line, I overheard some moron asking Jim to hand him his tobacco. Jim was paying protection to this baldy thug. So ever so politely, I asked the thug what he was doing and that my cuz was not giving him anything. This thug attacked me. We fought. He basically got more hits at me than I did him. He burst open my nose and gave me a sore jaw. We were both separated by the guards, also thumped by the guards with their batons and then put into the hole, which is solitary confinement. This was a wee cell downstairs and quite a dark place. The moron was put in the cell next to me and making lots of threats of who he was, what he was going to do with Jim and I, how big he was. While he was shouting this from the next cell, I just tried to drown him out by singing mainly T-Rex Sweet and Slade songs. This seemed to get him more angry. Could have been my singing. Then again, my choice of lyrics in the songs, Truck on Tyke, Teenage Rampage, Squeeze Me, Please Me. Yeah, these songs really got to him. The next morning we were in front of the governor of the prison, who as a punishment made us wash the hall floors on our knees with a bucket and cloth, and also took away all our privileges. Silly wardens never really thought this through, and allowed me and this moron to do the floors together. Short story was, he threatened me every day for almost a week, and when the warden one day left us alone to sneak off for a fly smoke, I hit him over the head with a steel bucket, splitting his head open in three places. Plus I was putting the boot into him several times, and these boots were very heavy. So damage was done. Yes, I was back in the hole for 3 days this time, but the thug never bothered us again. Plus I never got to wash floors again. Sadly, when I got out, I was back on jobby duty. As they say, shit happens.